Chair, thank you. I wanted to make an application bearing in mind that the report before you tonight on this matter is based on social media coverage, which is from myself. I wish to address the meeting myself for the allotted 5 minutes or whatever it is.
Well, thank you, Mr. Swans, for pressing the and I'm going to decline that request in this occasion because Ms. Scotty's group officially represents, I believe, the residents and their concerns at this particular item. He applied to speak to this committee well in advance, and I think the social media coverage you are referring to, the report or reference to it, does not put in debate to yourself.
Development thank the committee for listening to us now.
Thank you, Mr. Wright. You've finished ahead of time.
I didn't mention anything about the developer.
I'm just going to run the topics into to present the council's report before I take questions from the committee of the officers or Mr. Crockett. Please, are you taking this back, please?
Thank you, Chair. I'm also joined by Alison Knight, the Executive Director of Neighbourhoods and Search and Public Monitoring. Also, it's clear at the time of the first report to the Asset Management Disposal Committee that the thought process and audit trail behind the initial discussions again should be documented and provided that evidence. There was a thought process. dealing with this as we go forward, with the fact that we didn't carry out all the previous measures that we would have preferred to have carried out in the past, perhaps you'll be able to tell me this. I don't know what a development option is, but somebody fill me in on what a development option involves and the sort of monies it costs to do it.
Whether the land would be
committee saying, no, we don't think this is suitable for a variety of reasons, or even a single reason. We don't think it's an appropriate development. The option remains for the developer to buy this piece of empty land on the mine farm as it is. Is that correct?
Yes, but they would effectively acquire a piece of land without planning consent, which begs the question of what they want to do. So the option is really enabling the developer to make some preliminary inquiries to work out a potential proposal, knowing that there are other conditions that would need to be met other than being planning consent, and that would be subject to the usual planning processes. The planning committee would determine that independently of an option agreement. So those hurdles would be have to be met in the usual way. This option really enables the developer to work up the development, and knowing that these hurdles will have to be overcome, there's no guarantee that they would be, but that's part of the risk that the developer is willing to take in relation to this development.
So there's no fine, should come back on the council, should the planning committee decide that it's outside the UDP and wants it to
develop? As long as the council's committed itself reasonably in accordance with those options, then there's no breach of contract arguments. These are risks that the developer is taking on, knowing about planning consent, or supporting planning consent, issues with regards to the trust, etc., are all live issues that will need to be addressed, which don't affect the council's position, as long as the council's committed is reasonably with regards to its obligations of the agreement.
But what if the developer fulfills the conditions?
Councillor Chairman.
And just leading on from that, presumably there have been no assurances that
the obligations are planning consent will follow planning consent processes as they would in the normal way. Likewise, we have spoken to be satisfied with the issues to itself and the issues and proposals being put forward, likewise, consent being obtained from the trust will be able to.
Any other questions from members to either the officers or Mr. Crockett? Mrs. Sally.
Thank you, Chair. So thank you, Mr. Crockett. I'm pleased that the action you're going to say, but that's part of this sort of agreements that the council needs to make. It's some of this that goes to court with the committee is by observation.
Mr. Chair, we're finding it very difficult to hear up here. If I could ask people to speak up.
The members of the public gallery, the members make sure that they speak directly into their microphones. I'll ask Mr. Hussain to repeat his question to the officers.
I'll repeat the question. Only it's mostly observation. It was just reflecting on the process at the time of the decision being taken. I just wondered if the decision-making process was underpinned in any way, did the process require any form of engagement with resident stakeholders leading into the decision being taken and discussed?
No, it didn't.
Thanks. I mean, we've heard from Mr. Crockett and sort of, you know,
concerns is going on things like pollution and all the rest of it. How long is the current option applicable for? Because this seems to have been hanging over their heads for 5 years so far, and hopefully we can get some sort of speedy resolution sorted in this. Does the developer have a time scale? Time they must apply for planning permission or his option runs out? And they just keep hanging on forever?
Release the option.
In relation to the option itself, there's a provision for a secondary agreement. The secondary agreement does include a time limit of 12 months for the reciprocal agreement. Within that period,
what, sorry?
12 months of the secondary agreement being entered into without having consent and the other condition would be to be
consent.
Secondary agreement has yet to be entered into. So this is very much about getting the options or the conditions in relation to the first.
Ridiculous.
Any other questions from the committee?
Absolutely ridiculous.
Sorry, just a quick one. You say the developer has to move to the second stage. So do we have to move to the second stage? I mean, we can't allow someone to keep dictating this thing forever.
It's a joint move towards the secondary agreement. The initial option was to get things ready to move towards the secondary agreement, and that is the point that we're at now.
Rubbish.
What we're looking at is moving towards that secondary agreement, as Thomas goes on, and the developer will then be moving towards other goes of planning permission and consultation and all the future things. But that is also moving towards that secondary agreement with the developer, which we've got next time scales on.
Okay, well, for the sake of Mr. Covington, his name is Gilles.
The developer's got restrictions on four land titles. She just said they won't do it.
I'm really sorry, I can't, I'm new to this process, I can't hear. I don't understand why you brought it forward, so I've missed half of it. But at least can you make it available for me to hear what you're saying now, because I can't hear a word you're saying.
I've reminded members and officers to speak directly to the house. This is being webcast currently. It will be available for a number of days on the council website after this meeting. I brought it forward because we have a very long meeting this evening over considering the safety of accounts. It could go on quite some time. I didn't want you waiting here for potentially 2 hours for your item to come up. So it was out of hospitality for you as guests of ours that we will be brought it forward this evening. I will continue to remind members and officers to speak directly to their microphones. The microphone is not an excuse to whisper. Speak to normal volume, and I will, with this meeting, will be available to be watching the webcast. Sorry, Alison, you must carry on.
Yes, what I said was that we would consider that at the chair's request for within our future processes.
She said they don't do it.
Considering the criticisms that
I still can't hear. I request that you talk into your microphone rather than turn away.
Look, I've been very, very patient with interruptions from the public gallery.
I'm sorry.
We can't hear Liam.
Can I just say something? I don't know the procedure. It's the first time I've been.
Yeah.
I've missed half of it because you brought it forward without our knowledge. Yeah. And that lady insists on looking at you rather than to her microphone.
It's,
so
it's
I can't
the
hear
procedure to address the chair. Okay? That is procedure. Now, I'm happy with how Oxford have conducted themselves in terms of their volume at the moment. I'm sorry if you can't hear it. It will be available for you to rewatch at your own leisure on the council website for a number of days afterwards if you want clarification of how many days you can ask a member of staff. Any more questions for the committee? Any more questions from the committee? No. And the recommendation in the report, I believe, just to note it. We've added our own recommendation there. We've just voted and accepted. So, excluding that one, do members accept the recommendations as laid out in the report at the moment?
Yeah. Whitewash.
Any against? Any abstentions? No. That's fine.
Absolute whitewash.